गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स. सो वी स्टार्टेड प्रॉब्लम्स रिलेटेड विद द थ्रेडेड जॉइंट्स इन द यस्टरडेज लेक्चर्स. आई एक्चुअली वीडियो शूट बट ड्यू टू सम ऑफ द टेक्निकल प्रॉब्लम्स रिलेटेड विद मोबाइल्स, माई मोबाइल्स, सो आई कांट अपलोड. दैट इज ऑन द यूट्यूब्स एंड दैट means that is not captured in my mobiles, so that's why today I guess continue the remaining portions of the threaded joints. We studied when the load is perpendicular to the axis, means that times the stresses, means because of the eccentric loading, the stresses induced, that is primary shear stress and secondary shear stresses, and in when the load is perpendicular, so that times the stresses induced are shear stresses and tensile stresses. So today we'll see when the load is parallel to the axis of the shaft, so what are the different types of the stresses induced. Suppose this arrangement this is wall, this is bracket, this is web, and here's cylinder is attached. This is cylinder attached, and here's this is bolted joint. Now this is front view, and suppose this is side view. Again this bracket, suppose this is A and this is B, and if this is tilting edge and this distance is the L1 and this distance is the L2. Suppose and here load is attached, that is P. And this distance equal to, suppose this distance equal to capital L. L. Now, because of the this load is tensile loads, so that's why the stresses induced in the here's that are primary tensile, and this bracket may be tilt because of the loads, and this is delta 1 and this is delta 2. This is clear. So as you know, now design procedures, so what may be the loads, this primary tensile force acting on each bolts equal to P divided by number of bolts. So in this case total is, because this is A, this is B, so this is 1 and 2, and suppose this also 1 and 2, and this is 3 and 4. So that's why total number of the bolts for this case, this is equal to, so this is primary tensile force acting on the bolts. So next, because of the this eccentric loads, so the another type of the stress is induced, that are due to tilting, secondary tensile stresses induced in the threaded joints. So secondary tensile stress in each bolts, and this is equal to, and this is suppose PT 1 dash PT 2 PT 3 PT 4, this is equal. For this case, now PT 1 double dash PT 2 double dash equal to C into L1, and PT double dash equal to PT4 double dash equal to C into L2, because this depends on the this distance L2 for third bolt and fourth bolt. This is the secondary tensile force. Now, as you know, load is directly proportional to stress, because stress equal to what is formula? Since stress equal to P by A, so that's why you can consider this is stress or load, because here load is acting, and that is stress, and stress is directly proportional to strain, and strain is directly proportional to stretch. So that's why stress equal to strain multiplied by E. So that's why you can conclude stress is directly proportional to strain, and strain equal to delta L by L. So this is strain equal to directly proportional to delta L. So that's why this load that is directly proportional to this distance. So we have to calculate now C equal to, so C equal to PL by equating, here's P, suppose this is equation first, by equating opposite moments, P into L equal to 2 into PT 1 oblique 2 double dash multiplied by distance L1 plus 3, 4 double dash L2. That's why now foot, this is equal to, by putting PT 1, 2 equal to C into L1, and PT 3rd and 4th equal to C into L2. So this equations becomes directly L1 square 2 into C L2 square. That's why C equal to PL divided by, and PT 1 double dash PT 2 double dash equal to PL divided by L1 2L1 square plus L2 square and this is L2, because yes, this is depends on the distance L2, and this is 2L1 square plus L2 square. Now after knowing, so the load on the third bolt and fourth bolt is more for this case. So that's why PT3 equal to PT4 equal to combination sum of the PT3 single dash and PT3 double dash equal to. And after that we have to equate sigma T equal to P by A, and this P A equal to pi by 4 DC squares DC equal to under root 4P divided by pi into sigma T, and D equal to DC divided by 0.8. This is design procedures for this is the threaded joint when the load is parallel to the axis of bolt. And this is the third case. To the axis of the bolt. This is clear. Now I erase this. So note down today's process. Briefly, I am writing, this is a cast iron bracket fixed to the steel structure is shown in figure. You can take this figure. It supports a load of it supports a load of 25 kilonewton, therefore two bolts, so here this is given, two bolts at A and two bolts at B. The distances are as follows. The distances are as follows. L1 equal to 50 mm. L2 equal to 200 mm, L equal to 400 mm. Determine the size of the bolt if maximum tensile stress in the bolt is 50 N/mm². This is given. Now you are familiar because this is the case when the load is parallel to the axis of the bolt. And this is L1 equal to 200 up to 50. And this is L2 200 and L equal to 400 mm. P equal to 25 kilonewtons. So that's why briefly I am writing this is primary shear force, primary tensile force acting on the each bolts. This is equal to P divided by number of bolt this is 6250 newton means primary tensile force acting on each bolts equal to 6250 newtons. Now you are familiar how to calculate the C equal to formula PL divided by 2 L1 squares plus L2 square. P equal to 25,000 L distance 400 and this is 50 square plus 200 square. C equal to multiplied by 2, 1 divided by answer, multiplied by 50 square plus 200 square. Multiplied by 2 divided by answers multiplied by 25,000 multiplied by 400 this is C equal to 117.64 newton per mm. Now, as you know, for third bolt and fourth bolt, and this is tensile equal to C into L2, 117.64 L2 equal to 200 and this is equal to 25,529 newton, right? And resultant force this is equal to PT3 6250 plus 6250 this is 29,777. So once again I will check, this is 25529 plus 6250 because this is 23,523,529 plus 6250 29 779 newton. Now you can calculate sigma t equal to pt divided by a, and this is resultant force acting on the each means third bolt, because chances of the third bolt and fourth bolt is more, so that's why 779 divided by a, and this is given 50 newton a equal to. This is 595.58. Now we can put a equal to pi by 4 dc squares equal to 595.58 dc equal to under root 1 by pi into, now only divided by pi, dc equal to 27.53 mm, and d equal to dc divided by 0.8, 30.4.42 mm, so that's why size above the bolt equal to, you can consider this is expected size above the bolt is the M36 or M40. And this is third type of the problems. Now, fourth type of the problems, when the load is eccentric load, and that is acting on another circular base. Eccentric load on circular base. This is fourth type of the problems. Note down problems. The bracket is bolted to the support and subjected to the load of 25 kilonewton as shown in figure. The bolts are made of C8 sigma yt 380 newton per mm squares. If the required factor of safety is 1.85 find the size of the bolt. For this case, this is bracket. Four settings, 20 kilonewton, and this distance equal to 225. And this is tilting edge. Now its base is circular. And arrangements bolt, and this is this space and the bolts. Suppose this is first bolt, this is and this is right. Suppose this distance is the small r and this is capital R. Because we require more space. So first I will mark, this is 1, this is 2, this is 3, this is 4. This angle is given 25 degree. So that's why here's, now here's, in this case, because load is perpendicular to the axis of the bolt, so that's why shear stress induced in each bolts, shear force induce in each bolts equal to PS1, PS2, PS3, PS4 equal to P divided by number of bolts. This is general formula. P equal to 20,000 divided by 4, and this is equal to 5,000 Newton. This is clear. Now here's this bolts, here's first bolts, here's second, this is fourth, and this is third. So this distance is the L1, this is L2, and this is L4, and this is L3, and this is, so that's why, can I write, this is L1, L2, L4, and this is L3. So L3 distance is the greater. So we have to calculate C equal to formula P into 225 divided by L1 square plus L2 square plus L3 square plus L4 square. That's why we requires value of the L1, L2, L3 and L4. Now I draw these diagrams for understanding purpose, for bolt first. this is center, and suppose this is tilting edge, and this is first bolt. This distance equal to suppose B, and this is equal to A, and this distance equal to L1. Right? This distance equal to L1, or you can say this distance equal to L1. Now, this angle is the 25 degree. So, what is we request? This is L1. That's why. Can I take here? Yes, this is cos alpha equal to general formula. Front side divided by diagonal. Now, front side, this is adjacent side. This is adjacent side. So, adjacent side equal to this total is the A. This distance is the total is the A. So, that's why now put cos 25 equal to adjacent side equal to total distance A. And this distance means equal to A minus L1, L1 divided by B. Now, by cross multiplications, B cos 25 equal to A minus L1. Take this L1 in left hand side, and this is in the right hand side. This is suppose first equation. Similarly, I will consider the second and this is tilting edge. This edge is the tilting edge. This distance is equal to B, and this is A. Now, this total distance, suppose this distance is the L2, right? And again, because we consider this distance equal to A. So that's why now this is alpha. Sin alpha equal to front side divided by diagonal. So what is front side? A minus L2 divided by diagonal equal to B. This is sin alpha. That's why sin 25 equal to A minus L2 B. B sin 25 equal to A minus L2, or L2 by taking this L2 in the left hand side, A minus B into sin 25. This is second. Same equations, because A equal to this A is nothing but, this is capital R, B is nothing but small r, this is general formula, right? And similarly, L2 equal to R minus small r sin 25. Now, this is, because this distance is the less, similarly, because here for this case, L3 equal to, now you can R plus R cos 25, and L4 equal to R plus R sin 25. This is third, and this is fourth equation, right? Now, we will calculate L1 equal to, L1 equal to, R equal to 250 minus 200 cos 25, L1 equal to 250 minus 200 cos 25 equal to 68.73 mm. This is L1 equal to. Now L2 equal to this is 250 minus 200 sine 165.47 mm. L3 equal to 250 plus 200 into cos 25. This is 431.26 mm. L4 equal to 250 sine 25. This is 34.52 mm. L4 equal to. Right? Now you can calculate C equal to. Value of C equal to P 20,000, L equal to 225, and this is L1 68.73 square plus 165.47 square plus 431.26 square plus 334.52 square. C equal to square plus 13.63 newton per mm. Now load on the third bolt is more, so that's why, and this is tensile. PT3 equal to C into L3, 13.63 multiplied by L3 equal to 431.26, and this is equal to 5880. Now according to the maximum shear stress theory, you can use 0.5 into sigma yt divided by factor of safety, and this is equal to half sigma t square plus 4 tau squares. That's why, can I write here, yes, this is 0.5380 sigma t equal to, and this is 5000 divided by a bracket square plus 4 bracket square, right? 0.5 multiplied by 380 divided by 1.8. This is, I guess, 380. Factor shift is 1.8, na? 1.8 divided by 1.8 multiplied by 0.5. This is 105.55. Now, I take as common A under root 5000 squares 5880 squares. Directly I am writing now 0 square multiplied by 4 plus 5000 square under root divided by 2, and this is 6389 A 55 A equal to divided by 0.55 60.53 pi by 4 dc squares 60.53 dc equal to multiplied by 4 divided by pi, and this is directly under root 8.77, right? And divided by 0.8, 10.97. So that's why we require size of the bolt equal to M12s. This is the your required answers. Means size of the bolts required for this such type of the brackets when the load is 20 kN is the M12s. So I think I completed all varieties of the problems related with the threaded joints as per the given syllabus, because this chapter is big. So in this chapter, threaded joint, welded, riveted joints and power screw. So that's why if any important problems related to these chapters, threaded joints or this topic, I will take it in the next class. Otherwise, we'll start next subtopic, means topic is the welded joint. Thank you.